This past year, the struggle to enact health care reform was fought by the president and the Congress in Washington. Now, with the law on the books, the battle to shape it has expanded to include states and the courts. This week, we report from two states that are taking sharply different approaches since the election. First, Wisconsin. New resistance there is aimed at many aspects of the law, especially at a program the law aims to expand to cover more people, Medicaid. NewsHour correspondent Betty Ann Bowser has our report.
Every December, children flock to the Capitol building in Madison to see Wisconsin's state holiday tree and its sea of dazzling colors. But inside the halls of power these days, there's only one color that resonates, red. That's because on November 2nd, Republicans made a political clean sweep, taking the governorship, the state legislature, two U.S. congressional seats, and a U.S. Senate seat away from the Democrats. And one of the issues that turned Wisconsin from blue to red was health care.
We all live in Wisconsin together.
Within days of his election, Governor-elect Scott Walker made it clear he'll go to court to challenge the new federal health care reform law. The incoming leadership in the legislature is behind him 100%. 46-year-old Republican Scott Fitzgerald is the new majority leader in the state Senate. His younger brother, Jeff, will be Speaker of the Wisconsin Assembly.
We now have, obviously, with the Republican governor, the ability to allow our attorney general to join in on the nationwide lawsuit.
They expect the state to join 20 others in a federal court case in Florida. That suit challenges the constitutionality of the provision in the new law that requires most Americans to buy health insurance.
What it will do is, kind of change the debate here. And so far that debate has been about how will it be implemented, how will we adapt, what effect will it have on the programs that we already have in place.
Under your tongue, please.
Both brothers fear the new law will mean higher health care costs. At a time when Wisconsin has a $3 billion budget deficit, high unemployment, and a ballooning Medicaid population.
We're scared to death about what's coming down the pike as we still try to grasp exactly what impact Obamacare will have on Wisconsin.
What are you scared of?
And we have a problem with the cost of health care. That's the real problem at hand. And there's nothing in there that's going to curb costs. We would like to see a market-driven health care economy, put some stuff into place that will make it consumer-driven again. And unfortunately, what we see is just more bureaucracy.
Like, my leg is visibly swollen because
of... One of the programs Republicans want to cut is Medicaid. In Wisconsin, it's called Badger Care. Jason Stein covers a state house for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel.
Medicaid in Wisconsin is a multi-billion dollar program. One in five people in Wisconsin are on some form of Medicaid, whether they're in a nursing home or they're receiving long-term care at home or they're receiving health care, what we would typically think of health care at a doctor, at a clinic, at a hospital. Right now, this program has expanded dramatically since 2007.
The recession has driven thousands of the unemployed to sign up for the first time, dramatically increasing the size of the program.
It's a very challenging thing for politicians to take away health care coverage from people.
Bobby Peterson is among a group of health care activists who thinks Republicans will make it harder for people to qualify for Medicaid. They've organized Save Badger Care, bringing in advocates from all over the state to lobby against cuts.
Mistakes are made, and certainly wouldn't want you to fall through the cracks.
The new recipients are childless adults, a category not covered in most states. But under a waiver obtained from Washington last year by outgoing Democratic governor and health care reform supporter Jim Doyle, Badger Care was expanded to include them. 64,000 new people qualified for the program. Today, another 80,000 are currently on waiting lists.
They're going to increase the hoops and hurdles for people who are trying to get through the program.
Like what?
More administrative barriers. So instead of saying, we can let you sign up online on the internet, we're not going to do that anymore. You have to go to the county office to sign up. Instead of paycheck verifications for the last two paychecks, we'll say the next four paychecks.
Matt Vogel is a childless adult who signed up last summer. He suffers from chronic pancreatitis and has been unable to hold a steady job. Before he qualified for the program, he had no insurance.
I don't have to worry if I have to go to the ER because I'm having an attack. I can look them in the eye and I know they're going to get paid. I know, and that's a big help. I don't feel like a pariah.
But Vogel and thousands like him could be dropped from the program next year if he makes too much money.
Have you been?
Dr. Ian Gilson is an internist who's been seeing a rash of new Badger Care patients like Vogel. He says many of them hadn't been to a doctor in years, although they suffered from serious conditions like diabetes and hypertension.
We got these people, for the most part, straightened out. We got proper lab testing. We got them on the right medications. Their diabetes improved. Their blood pressure came down. In some respects, they're actually feeling better. But we also knew that as we were doing this, we were preventing disasters down the road.
Governor-elect Walker has not been specific about what cuts he would make to Badger Care, but he gave a hint at one of the gubernatorial debates this fall.
Yeah, I think it's appropriate over time to move people into jobs so that the dollars we do have for Medicaid can be spent on people truly needy in our state, and I'll continue that as governor.
The NewsHour tried repeatedly to get a one-on-one interview with the governor-elect, but a spokesman turned us down, citing scheduling problems. And although Wisconsin Republicans complain about the growing Medicaid population, federal stimulus money is helping pay for much of it. That money protects family coverage, so states cannot change eligibility standards right now. But when the stimulus money runs out next July, Wisconsin then would be allowed to change some categories of eligibility, potentially ending coverage for about 70,000 parents and childless adults. Then, in 2014, when key parts of the federal health reform law kick in, federal money is expected to cover nearly all of the new people who qualify for Medicaid in most states for 3 years. Until then, states are struggling to close large deficits, and they must follow the rules to continue receiving their current and new federal assistance.
One of the big issues that we have here in Wisconsin is money.
Democratic State Assemblyman John Richards, who's about to lose the chairmanship of the Assembly's Health Committee to a Republican, says there's a lot of money on the line for Wisconsin. $4 billion a year in federal matching funds the state could lose if it tampers too much with Medicaid.
We're running a huge budget deficit, and every time they talk about turning back the federal health care law, they're talking about blowing a huge hole in our budget that they're going to have to fill because our Constitution requires us to have a balanced budget.
Besides Medicaid, states like Wisconsin will also be able to control how they set up health insurance exchanges, places where people can go online, compare insurance plans, and buy affordable coverage. Pam Hurd is an associate professor of public affairs at the University of Wisconsin.
Scott Walker has made it pretty clear that he wants a very, very limited regulation of plans that participate in the exchange. And the state, it doesn't look like at least, will get really involved in terms of negotiating on behalf of citizens for things, for benefits and the cost of the plans.
The Fitzgerald brothers want the exchanges to be free market driven with a minimal amount of state government involved.
The slower we can proceed and kind of get our ducks in a row, the better off we'll be. If the exchange is driven by ultimately, you know, government bureaucrats making the decisions that are currently made by some of the private sector health insurance corporations, it's going to put us in a bad position.
And Brother Jeff does not want to see Wisconsin have to do what some say the federal government will have to do, hire more people to administer portions of the law.
Just the figure that's staggering to me is just to, you know, from the IRS standpoint, 15,000 new employees have to be added just to, you know, administer Obamacare and look at the tax implications.
Democrats in Wisconsin say they'll fight efforts to turn back health care reform, including cuts to Medicaid. So the winter ice may be long gone before the future of the state's medical plan is clear.